Hello again, Khonius here. Tonight I'm flying from San Diego to Ensenada Airport in Mexico. I'll be flying a Cessna 208 B Grand Caravan at a flight level of 5,700 feet. I'll let autopilot take over for majority of the flight for a nice smooth viewing flight. Anyway, let's get started. So I'll gain some altitude before handing over to autopilot. I'll put us on course first. Okay, I put the flaps up so we're getting some speed.
K255, continue for south departure. I will contact you next when you leave my airspace.
Lindbergh Tower KH255, continue for south departure.
I want to get a little higher before I turn over to autopilot, just to give it a safety margin, essentially. Okay. So I've already turned nav on. Let's hand it over to autopilot. And I've set a flight level of 5,700, so once it stabilizes on the course, take us up to that level, and then we can start looking around. The moon looks beautiful. And all the city lights. I'm taking all these flights in real time, and so I was driving earlier, and the moon looked pretty much just like that in the sky. It was eerie.
Hey, 255, you are leaving my airspace. Frequency change approved.
Lindbergh
Tower KH255 frequency change.
Zigzag a little bit here.
SoCal approach KH255 is type Cessna Caravan, 3 miles southeast of Lindbergh, 2,400 feet. Request clearance to transition Bravo airspace.
Maybe not. I don't know.
KH255 SoCal approach. Squawk 0753.
Squawk 0753 KH255.
I'll just let it
radar contact 4 miles southeast of Lindbergh, 3,000 feet. Cleared through the Bravo airspace.
Probably I should hand off
cleared
once
the Bravo airspace
it
KH255.
Just has to keep the heading. It doesn't have to actually get us back on track. It seemed like that was a little easier with the smaller plane. In this plane, I noticed that
contact Imperial Beach approach on 133.175.
133.175 KH255. Imperial Beach approach KH255, 3,900 feet.
Once we level off, I will let off the throttle a bit.
Continue as planned. Altimeter
290.902. Alright, so let me go ahead and engage. Getting its bearing on heading up. We're not that far off, actually. I think actually it just switched it to altitude hold mode. So I think I'm running the engine a little hot according to the gauge over in the rain. Seems like the autopilot's struggling a little bit to get exactly on level. Anyway, let's go ahead and take a look outside. It's a beautiful night. We're heading into Mexico. I'm not sure exactly where the border is. Somewhere along here. I don't think we've reached it yet. We might be a little bit soon to have reached it, but we'll see. Yeah, there's some curls each. One of the destinations I considered, but it was a little close. I think we'll pull back on the throttle because we're at level altitude. Back inside for a bit, it's a little quieter in there. I wonder if I can figure out how to dial down the intensity. I tried before and I couldn't really tell. That was one thing. The other thing is I still haven't figured out how to turn on the cabin lights. That's inoperative. So maybe you can't. I know there's a way to turn a flashlight on, I'm not sure. These are a little bright for nighttime. expect the controls to be somewhere that's fuses and things. So, I don't know. I'll figure it out later. Alright, I'd like to be a little lower. I want to be able to see the instruments a little better than that. Okay. So, once you're in the cabin, you can continue using the Xbox controller, and then it works in the way I'm used to, so it switches orientations. It's a little hard to get used to. The other thing is, if you're in external view or in the cabin, don't hit the left joystick because it affects the control surfaces, because you're meant to fly with the Xbox controller. Seeing some reflection off the glass up here from the G1000, maybe. Alright, I'm gonna go back outside. You can see better, it's not so glaring. Well, no more city lights though now that we're in Mexico, I guess. So, goodbye America, hello Mexico. This area is not more developed. But I have noticed a stark difference. You look on the US side of the border down there, and just things like the mountains and the greenery look healthy, and then on the Mexico side it looks kind of gray and like nothing wants to grow there. So G1000 and the cockpit from there. That's interesting. Pretty zoom in. That's cool. That'll make a nice shot for the clips at the end. So I feel like I'm getting better at flying the 208B. I'm having a better time at keeping things stable while I'm doing things at the right time. Landing while in the cockpit rather than outside like a video game. So that feels nice. I feel what I'm lacking though is some basic knowledge about aeronautics, about the way wind acts in certain cases and some other stuff, so I might look online and see if I can find some crash courses on some of that stuff. I think it would help knowing when surprising things happen, it might help to know why. So I'd really like to get the drone in a similar position. Let's see. Wrong. Panel. Camera panel. Showcase. Reset position. So if it's on the lock mode, I think it'll rotate around the same way as the external view. Thank you. It might help to reduce clarified backup maybe a little bit. Sit up. Kind of see outside. A little bit. Not much. Curious what it looks like to zoom in on some of the terrain when it's this dark out, but it just looks like you'd expect, I think. I'm a little surprised I'm not seeing planes flying in this area. I would have expected to see something flying by. Now, of course, there's a whole lot less air traffic, and maybe the game hasn't penetrated far into Mexico yet. But we seem to be out here by ourselves. I'm gonna go outside and look back. Yeah, we're just out here by ourselves. I don't see anything. Dropping fast, but the angle's fine, the engine speed's fine. I'm sure it's not a problem. I still have not turned damage back on. I should do that. I was troubleshooting some things and turned that off and forgot to turn it back on. So now we're leveling off. We're not really giving it much throttle because we're going to need to start slowing down, but we don't need to slow down yet, so I'm going to just sort of stay in the mid-range somewhere. Wind seems relatively calm. Weather's beautiful and clear. I could see Ensenada from here. We can actually zoom in on that. Let's see. Okay, cool. That's about the level of detail I would expect that far away. Take over from autopilot. slowing down just a little bit. Not sure which side of the airport the landing pattern entry is going to show up on, so I'll just keep heading towards it. The co-pilot should contact them any moment, I believe. Happy with the speed we're going. When we get closer, I will put the flaps down. Seems like he usually contacts them about 10 or 11 nautical miles out.
Tower KH-255, 1 miles northwest to land.
KH-25,
flight tower.
Flight straight in runway 11. Altimeter
290.91
and 25, 8 of 6.
Make straight in runway 11 KH-255.
Okay, so let's head over to the opening. Guess how far to turn. Now I can actually see it, so that helps me judge. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and put the flaps down. And bring the throttle down. I'm having to lean really hard on the stick at the moment. I was going a little fast maybe. Sometimes it can be a little hard to judge the shape and exactly where the entrance is for the landing pattern, but this time it's nice and clear. And I do need to be going slower, that's why it's red, and turn another color when we're going at acceptable speed. Moving the flaps down a little bit more. And again, leaning on the stick, dropping the throttle, trying to get down. Below 75, I believe, or something like that. A little high, so might have to just burn off some of this height. So you can use up some of that energy on controlled surfaces by turning. Slow down by doing serpentine moves, or in some cases just dipping up a little bit.
KH-255, clear to land runway 11. 1258 of 6.
do need to be going
clear
slower.
To land runway 11KH255.
Alright, so we're in Ensenada, Mexico. This is kind of exciting. It's nighttime, almost like a secret midnight flight or something. Yeah, still too fast. That's okay. We've got a long time to slow down. So now I just have to balance my altitude, my speed, my throttle. Steering should be easy, the wind is calm. I find what I need to do, precision steering, two hands on the stick is better than one, but I think a real yoke would actually be even better, so at some point I plan to invest in one. Okay, I can afford to get some altitude, get down to the right speed at this point. But not to the point where I stall the plane. That would not be good, so... But at least we're going within an acceptable speed now, so that's a good thing. I'd like to know more about how the wind, how the air acts as you get closer to the runway, because I've noticed interesting effects, and I feel like if I knew more about that, it'd be easier to predict what's going to happen and have safer landings. And there's certain kind of ground effects, I just need to learn about that, I think. Feels like we're going really slow, but we're going, you know, really fast freeway speeds. And with the flaps down, our stall speed is the bottom of that white line, heading that direction, but as long as I keep it under 75, it'll be okay. And it's interesting, I can remember taking flights with a long, you know, landing pattern, and you can feel the pilot letting off the throttle and then picking it up again as he drops a little bit too much. And actually, these days it's probably not the pilot, it's probably the unweighted landing systems. Alright, well, I believe I see runway lights. We're going a nice speed. I'd like to go a little slower, but we'll get there by the time I get to the tarmac, I think. I'm going to slow down just a little bit, though. Just sort of a judgment call, given where I see the airport, or where I see the tarmac. I think I can afford to drop it a little bit more and just glide in. Alright, so at some point you just have to drop it all, so I think we're in a good position to do that. So now I'm just going to try to get straight and level. Wreck the plane. Alright, so we bounced a little bit. That's not a big deal. No damage. Alright, and so now we need to get our butts off the runway. I'm not sure if we have to contact a tower or... Okay. At some point they'll figure out we landed. Communicate with us. We just need to steer off the runway, I think, and they'll talk to us. So I'm just looking for where an exit might be, maybe up here.
KH255, turn next taxiway.
Turn next taxiway. Okay, there we go. Perfect.
KH255, contact ground on 119.75.
Alright, so this is where I have to take over ATC knowledge.
Going to 119.75 KH255.
Once there's a decision to be made, now is when I would switch to ground services. And okay, we've already got taxi clearance to parking, so we're good there. F- flying on the ground is becoming more natural. I'm using the pedals and the throttle together, trying to stay below the 20 knot limit. That can be a little hard, but you can always slam on the brakes. It's also a little hard sometimes to tell how fast you're actually going on the ground. But I kind of get a sense. I know I'm probably going 22 or something. It's a little fast. Brake. I can hit the right brake and slow it down and turn at the same time, so that can be kind of handy, although this time I need some rudder too. Don't want to hit anything. Okay, we're good. Alright, so it looks like there's nobody to meet us here. I think it's just a parking spot or something. And that's it. I don't really see anything else. Let me look outside for a minute. It seems to just be wanting us to kind of move forward a little bit and stop, so that's what I'll do. Alright, that'll do, I think. Alright, so let me set the parking brake. Throttle's down. Shut the engine down. Let it go through its shutdown cycle. I love the sound it makes when it cools down. Alright, and then turn off the plane. If I can poke around here in the dark. Oh, wait, that was off. Interesting. Or it's backwards, or, oh. I think when I have a flashlight. Oh, interesting, I guess that must have kicked in automatically. All right, well, it didn't do the usual ceremonial ending of the flight, I guess because there's no real ground services. But anyway, that's it, folks. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video in Mexico.